Hello friends, welcome back to another video tutorial on SolidWorks mechanism. This is part 9 of SolidWorks mechanism tutorial series, and you can find my other videos on my channel. Okay, the channel name is CAD Gill. Okay, in this video tutorial we are going to create a Geneva mechanism. There are two types of Geneva mechanism: external Geneva mechanism and internal Geneva mechanism. In external Geneva mechanism, the slots are cutted outside the Geneva disk, okay, and this means away from the center of the Geneva disk. But in case of internal Geneva mechanism, the slots are cutted inside the Geneva disk toward the center of the Geneva disk. A Geneva mechanism is a mechanism which is used to transfer regular rotary motion to intermittent rotary motion. That means if you want to transfer a regular continuous rotary motion to stepped rotary motion, then a Geneva mechanism is used. I'm going to use the design data book data and some standard to design this Geneva mechanism. There will be some calculation, very basic, that I'm going to do. In the real case scenario, if you are going to design it for some industrial project, then the calculations are very complex and very heavy. Let me show you the design data. This is the Geneva mechanism first page from my PSG design data book. This PSG tech is from PSG College of Coimbatore, and their design data book is one of the best available. So you can see there, this is our Geneva mechanism, and there are slots cutted here, and there are many constraints here. You can see here the most important is Z is the number of slots on the driven disk. Let me zoom in. Z is number of the slots on the driven disk, and you can see there are so many constraints here. There are so many alphabets, symbols. Here is alpha, beta, a lot of them. Okay, but you don't have to be afraid of them. Okay, this is just the first page. Let me show you the next page. These are the design data standards. These are angular velocity, acceleration, their derivatives. Okay, these are the charts for angular acceleration and angular velocity for Geneva disk. This is for 3 slot, keep in mind. For 5 slot it will change. This is contact force diagram, and these are the equations for calculation of power, maximum power, average power, instantaneous power required on the driven shaft. You can calculate them easily. Okay, and you can also see there is material information at the lower end. Okay, so I will start designing now, but first we have to assume some things here. Okay, so let me tell you here, this E we have to assume here, this is the center distance. Okay, this diameter of this roller disk, we have to assume this also. We have to assume the this pin diameter also. Okay, everything else we will have to calculate it. Okay, so we have assumed the number of slots. Let's say we are going to assume 5, because visualizing 5 slots is easy, as you can see the diagram here. Okay, so let's start SolidWorks. I have started SolidWorks. Let's start it in assembly mode. Okay, now I would like to change the background to plain white. Okay, select top plane, sketch. Now center line and draw a vertical center line like this. Okay. Now a horizontal center line like this. Okay. Now another center line here also. So basically, this is the center point for the Geneva disc, and this is the center point for the roller disc here. So the center distance, let's assume it's 50 mm. Okay. Now we have to assume the diameter for the roller disc also. I'm going to assume it to be, let's say, 40 mm. Make the center point coincident on both the center lines. Okay, this should be fully defined. Okay, now we have to design we have to create a center line here like this. This is for the slot. Let me show you. This is the slot here. Okay, the angle here is alpha. Let's check out the value of alpha in next table. You can see that the value of alpha for 5 slots is 36 degree. So let's make this angle 36 degree here. Okay. Now we have an angle beta here. Beta is 54 degree. Okay. Keep in mind, we are going to use beta now. Beta is the angle between the vertical line and the center of the roller pin. Okay. Now let's draw a line from here like this, and the angle here is 54 degree. You can clearly see that 54 plus 36 is 90 degree. So this angle will be automatically 90 degree here, and same will be this angle here. Okay. And let me show you this in diagram, and you can see there is a 90 degree here. Okay. Now the roller pin is at a dia or distance of R. Okay. So let's draw a pin here like this. The dia of pin is, let's say, 8 mm. Now we have to do some calculations here. We can calculate the distance for the R graphically, or we can calculate it with, with equations also. Like you can see, R upon E is equal to sine alpha. E is the center distance here, 50 mm, and alpha is 36 degree. So we can easily calculate R is equal to E into sine alpha. Okay. Or we can just, we can clearly see that the center of this is coincident on the center line here. Okay. So let's make it coincident on this center line, and we will also calculate it here. Okay. So value of alpha is 36 degree. Okay. And then our center distance will be 50 into sine alpha. Press equal key now, and you can see the value here is 29.3893. Let's check it. It is nearly 29.38. 9.3. Okay, so you can clearly see that we can solve these kind of problems using equations by doing calculations, or we can also solve this graphically also, like we did in this case. Now we have to create the slots. I will draw a line here like this. Arc, okay, and a line here also again. Now make these symmetric about the center line, okay. Now keep in mind that this is going to be tangent, okay. For example, all of these are parallel to each other here, so this is going to be tangent to it, and you can see that this is completely fully defined here, okay. Now I will draw a circle like this here, and this circle is going to be tangent to this circle here, okay. Make this circle construction. This circle traces the path for the maximum distance of this rolling pin here, okay. You can see that this is the path here, so I can for this I can easily say that this will be the path for the slot here, okay. I can easily say that, and if this pin comes maximum here, I can easily say that then this slot should be tangent to this, okay. Let's make this construction. So we have constructed our slot also. Now we have to calculate this external R dash here, okay, and this diameter, this radius here, okay. The radius of this arc is going to be same as this outer radius here, R dash, okay. Let's check the value of R dash. R dash is corrected outside radius of Geneva wheel is equal to R into 1 plus RP square upon R square. Okay, let's check what is RP. RP is the radius of driver pin, okay, and R is the radius of Geneva wheel, okay. So the radius of Geneva wheel is the distance between the center to the this point, okay, at the entry of the pin in the slot. This is the radius of the Geneva disc, okay, but there is a corrected radius, so let's do calculations for that, okay. So the radius of the driving pin is 4 mm, because the diameter is 8, so radius will be 4, and the radius of Geneva disc is, let's calculate it also. It is going to be from this point to this point, okay. This is 40.45, okay. So let's calculate it now. So our value will be, let's assume it to be y, is equal to 40.45 into square root 1 plus brackets 4 divided by 40.45 raised to power 2, and then press equal key. Okay, so the radius, corrected radius of the Geneva disc is 40.6473. okay, so I will draw a circle here like this. Smart dimension, let's move it here, convert it into radius. The value of radius is 40.6473. Okay, okay, since we have just calculated this radius, let's calculate this value here also, okay. We can also calculate it using the formula. as I already shown you, 29.3893. So let's just, okay, it's okay, we can leave it like this. Now we have to use this angle gamma here. Okay, this gamma is important because this gives us the end point here for the arc. So I will just draw a center line. Let's go to second page and check the value of gamma. Gamma for Z is equal to 5 is 252 degrees. Okay, so let's make the angle 252 degrees. Okay, now let's create a arc from this point to this point. Okay, the radius of this arc is going to be same as this one. Create an equal constraint between these. Okay, now we have to create the lines for this roller pin. Let me show you which lines I am talking about. These, okay, these are coincident on this arc. Okay, you can also make them tangent to this, but I am going to do it like the book. Okay, create a line from this point to this. Okay, from this point to this. Now add tangent relations. Keep in mind I have not added any tangent relation between this line and this circle, and vice versa for this line and this circle. Okay, so basically we have created the sketch diagram for our Geneva mechanism. Now we will proceed to the 3D modeling. I will exit the sketch now. Now go to assembly tab, insert component, new part. Now click on this empty space here. Now select this part and press F2 key on your keyboard and write down Geneva disk. Right click this part, edit part, top plane sketch. Now select this circle and these here and click on convert entities. Now trim and trim down these here. Okay, now select these here and go to circular sketch pattern and 5 times. Okay, let's move it a little here so that we can fix the center of the circular rotation. Okay, now use the trim command again. Okay, this looks good. Let's extrude it 10 mm. Okay, we are going to use 10 mm because we have not calculated any force or these things. If you will calculate all those parameters, then you have to calculate the stress, etc., then the thickness will be, you have to assume it. But since we are going to do this for simple classroom work, a simple project, so we are not going to do that. Okay, so this is our Geneva disk. Let's create a hole at the center. Okay, for the hole dia, let's assume 10 mm. Okay, I will just select this face, sketch a circle. origin 10 mm, features extruded cut 10 mm, okay. Now exit this part, okay. We have created our Geneva disk. Now we have to create the roller disk. Insert component, new part, click on empty space here, select this part, press F2 key, and let's name it roller disk. Okay, now edit this part, top plane, sketch, normal tool. Okay, first select these three things here, convert entities, trim, okay, features, extruded base, 10 mm, okay. Now select this back face here. Now again we have to select this circle, these here all, okay. Convert entities, trim the inside edges, okay. Now let's extrude it also 10 mm. Okay. So this concludes our 3D modeling part. Before creating the simulation, we have to first make these parts float. Okay. Before doing that, select right click this part and external references and lock all. Repeat the same process with the second part. Okay. Now let's select both of these and right click float. Move these parts a little away. Okay. Now mate. Top plane. Select the back face here. Okay. Select this circular face and make it coincident with concentric with this circle. Okay. Now select the top plane again and this face. Okay. Concentric mate between these two. Okay. Click OK. Now let's hide the sketch here. We don't need it for the time being, okay. Now go to SolidWorks add-in and SolidWorks motion. Now go to motion study 1, expand the motion manager, motion analysis. Now select contact here. Click OK. Now select motor and select this face. For RPM, input value of 12. Reverse the direction, it should be like this. OK. Counterclockwise. Click OK. Now top plane. OK. Right click. Orientation and disable playback of view keys. Now click on calculate here. Okay. Okay, you can see that it worked perfectly here. I have looped it here. Okay, you can see. I have looped the playback. Now you can also create the chart for the velocity, angular velocity. Right click here and create motion plot, displacement, angular velocity, about y axis, select only this circular face, click OK. And you can see that the motion, when the here is the motion here, you can see it. It is in minus because we are rotating this counterclockwise, this motor. Okay, that's why this is negative here. If you want to create the motion plot for angular acceleration, right click here, create motion plot, displacement, angular acceleration, y component, select this circular face, click OK. And you can see the angular acceleration chart. You can see that there is a lot of variation here, and it is a lot of shaky. This is because there are contacts here, and this is actually contacting with each other. They are in contact with each other, and we are using physical contacts. That's why there are so many deviation here, and this is not smooth. Okay, but you can see that the for velocity it is very smooth. Let's create a motion plot for angular displacement. Oh, it's going to be a straight chart here. So friends, this concludes our video tutorial on Geneva mechanism modeling and simulation. If you liked this video tutorial, please click like and share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel for more such updates. You can check out my channel, and I have uploaded more such things. Okay, thank you for watching this video tutorial, and have a nice day.